now it's time to show you around your new web hosting account, show you around the control panel, and there's a couple things we need to do before we install WordPress. So all you need to do is visit InMotion Hosting. You might already still be there, and then you can always log in by clicking on this option right here that says AMP Login. So I'm going to go ahead and click on AMP Login, and it will take you to this login form. So I'm going to enter my login right now. Okay, now for me, because I have more than one account with them, it gives me the option here to choose which account I want to use to log in. So I'll just go ahead and choose the account that I'm going to use to log in. But for you, it's going to take you right on into the first control panel you'll see. Okay, so I'm now logged in. Now I am blurring out some of my private information, of course, which is reasonable. And I've got my billing information on the right blurred out. And this is the first place you go when you first log in. And this is where you're going to manage your account with InMotion. And you're really not going to do a ton here. You can obviously reach support right here on the top right. There's an option to contact support. You can update your contact information. If you have a bill, you can pay. You can reset your password. You can add domains and features and stuff like that to your account. And you have these options here. But where we're going to spend most of our time is this option right here that says cPanel. So go ahead and click on cPanel, which is, stands for control panel. And this is a industry standard. So no matter what web hosting company you do end up using, they're all probably going to be using this thing called cPanel. So go ahead and click on cPanel now. All right. So now I am in my cPanel. Now your cPanel is either going to look something similar to this, or there's a different view for it as well. So right here's my username dropdown. I'm going to choose change style, and it's going to give me the option of the style I'm in now, which is the modern looking style, and this classic style right here. So let me go into the classic style and see it's already switched. And when I click on home, it's going to go ahead and show me the classic style. And this is probably what most people are used to. But if I want to get into that other style, I can just go ahead right here and choose paper lantern, and it should take me over there. But I'm going to go ahead and use this one because it's the one that I'm most comfortable with. But either one that you're in, these different areas of your control panel are all going to have the same names. So it says file manager here. If I was to switch it by clicking right here in the top right there and clicking on change style, I can, jump back into the other one and then click on home, and it's the same thing. It still says file manager. So you can have whichever view you want, whether you want this view or the other view. Now, there are a bunch of things that you can do in here, and I don't want you to feel overwhelmed because you're not going to actually use most of them. So let me show you the things that we are going to be using mostly. So right now I'm going to scroll down and we're going to see this section that says emails. So one of the things that we need to do is create an email account that we're going to use on this WordPress website. And there's a bunch of things you could do here. So if this is going to be your business website, you'll obviously want to know how to create email accounts, and we'll do that right there. And for right now, we need to do one little techie thing. I want you to click right here where it says PHP configuration. And we need to change something. So by default, whenever you get a web hosting account, it's going to have this thing called PHP 5.6. And this is kind of an old one. So we want to change this to PHP 7. And what this is going to do is make everything twice as fast. So it's worth it to take this 1 minute and do this update. So I'm going to go ahead and click on update. And now it's saying we're going to be on PHP 7, which is exactly what we want. Let's go ahead and click on that home button again to get here. Now what I want to do is create an email account. So I'm going to go to email accounts right here. I'm going to click on that. And then this is how you create an email account. You just enter in what you want the front part of that email account to be. And then you'll put in a password, and then you'll choose a quota. Typically on that quota, we'll always choose unlimited. So I want this to be the email address that's used when your website is sending out emails. So you can choose whatever you think is going to be appropriate there. Now, With my website, I still like when it's sending out emails to have my name, that it will say Adam at whatever. So if you ever receive an email from my website, it's going to say Adam from WPCrafter.com. And that's just how I like to do it. So I'm going to go ahead and enter that in right now. But I've seen people use customer service or hello or support or orders or something like that. You can use whatever makes sense to you. But we're going to need this to plug into the WordPress website so that it's sending out emails from this email account. So I'm going to go ahead and enter Adam just like that. And I'm going to choose a password. Okay, so I entered in my password, and there's certain password requirements. So I'm going to go ahead and enter it again. Okay, and this is telling me that I've generated a strong password. Now you can use the password generator, but it's good to know what the password is, because there might be some times where you want to maybe take this email address and put it in your iPhone or your Android phone or your Outlook or your Apple Mail. So you might want to go ahead and have it be a password that you can remember. So I'm going to go ahead and choose unlimited, and then I'm going to click on create account. And it says right there that the account is created. Now, we keep in mind, we need this information moving forward in this video series. So make sure you make a note of it. Maybe just open up a notepad and write down the email address you created and write down the password that you created. And also, you'll be able to come in here in the future to change your password. And what I want to do right now, you could also delete your email account, but I want you to click on set up email client. And this is essentially going to give you all the settings right here that you need to configure it on your phone or your program, and also in this WordPress website. So we're going to use the info we have right here where it says secure SSL settings. Make a note of the outgoing server settings. So this is the outgoing server, because when we configure this on our website, we'll need to know this little piece of information right here. So go ahead and get a notepad and copy and paste that in there, and this port here. And you might want to also make a note of this incoming server right here as well, if you're going to configure this on any of your email clients. Now, right here is your non-SSL. SSL basically means it's going to be encrypted communication. So if you wanted to use an unencrypted communication from your device and your new web hosting account, you can use this information right here. But I'd recommend just going ahead and using the secure information right here, so all your email communication ends up being encrypted. So other than that, that's what we really needed to do in our cPanel. Let me just give it a quick glance over to see if anything else that you're going to need. From time to time, in some of my videos, I do things in the file manager, so that's good to know right there. If you wanted to make a backup of your entire cPanel account, you can make a backup right there. This database stuff, we're not going to touch directly. You can do some neat things here by adding a subdomain. That would be if I wanted to, say, put a website where it would be my.showthedemo.com. That's called a subdomain. You can do neat things like that if you wanted. And here is some DNS stuff. We're not going to talk about that in this video, but I talk about it in some of my other videos. Here's your email things. So we can create actually an email forwarder. That's interesting. So if you wanted to set up an email address on your domain name, such as orders@showthedemo.com, you don't actually have to create the email address. You can just make it so it'll forward someplace else. And so there's some neat things you could do right here. Metrics, this is just going to give you some stats on the usage of your web hosting account and the traffic that you're getting. Here's some security things right there. Software, advanced, let's see here, cron jobs. We won't be using that in this video. Now, in the next part of the video, we're going to actually use this section right here. So that's it for this overview of cPanel and your web hosting account. And the main thing we needed to do was upgrade your PHP to version 7. You never have to think about that again, by the way. And we wanted to go ahead and create that email account that we're going to use in this website that you are about to build.